الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters and dear viewers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن شاء الله we'll be talking about prophets and messengers in Islam and understanding the perspective of prophets and messengers in Islam. Islam is a unique religion, a great religion, that encompasses and includes everything about way of life and belief. In Islam, we have six important pillars as we must believe in. These are called the pillars of Iman. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Al-Imanu huwa an tu'mina billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi wal yawm al-akhir wal qadri khayrihi wa sharri. Iman is that you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you believe in the angels, you believe in his sacred books, you believe in the prophets and messengers. Believe in the prophets and messengers, believing in the day of judgment and believing in the divine destiny. Good and evil are both created by Allah Almighty. What we want to talk about is the fourth mentioned pillar of Iman, which does not mean it's fourth in ranking, but fourth mentioned pillar of Iman, which is the belief in prophets and messengers. Believing in the prophets and messengers is a very, very, very vital and important principle. We Muslims must believe in the existence of the prophets and messengers, and that Allah Almighty sent prophets and messengers to mankind. We Muslims believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent over 114,000 prophet and messenger throughout history, beginning with the first prophet, Adam alayhi salam, and ending with the last and final prophet and messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Someone might say and ask, but we only heard of 25. Yes, correct. Allah only mentioned 25 prophets and messengers in the Holy Quran. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not mention the rest 114,000 prophets and messengers, nor the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Maybe because there's no need to, and maybe because of another wisdom that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept to himself, almighty and glory. Allah azza wa jal did mention 25 prophets and messengers in the Holy Quran. And the reason that Allah azza wa jal mentioned 25 prophets and messengers in the Quran al-Karim, or those particular 25 prophets and messengers in the Quran al-Karim, as the scholars say, because they were the most elite prophets and messengers to Allah Almighty. So the first prophet and messenger is the first human being, and that's Adam alayhi salam. Adam alayhi salam is the first human being Allah Almighty created, and he was the first prophet and messenger. From him, the rest of the progeny and descent and offsprings of Adam come to this day, to the day of judgment. Throughout that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent so many prophets and messengers to their people. Adam alayhi salam, as the first prophet and messenger, as being also the first human being, him, his wife Hawa, and his children, they were all Muslims. This belief only entered in the offsprings of Adam alayhi salam, as the scholars say, 1,000 years after Adam alayhi salam. So this belief did not exist during the time of Adam alayhi salam, did not exist during the time of the direct children of Adam alayhi salam. It existed late and after Adam alayhi salam. When this belief started to exist, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even during the time of Adam, even after the time of Adam, Allah continued to send prophets and messengers to guide people. If they were Muslims, but they were misguided by committing wrong deeds and evil actions, these prophets and messengers were to guide them. And if they were disbelievers, these prophets and messengers came to take them out of disbelief to believe. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to send prophets and messengers throughout history from the time of Adam to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to different nations, to different states, to different cities, to different countries, to different villages. Some prophets and messengers came to a particular nation. Some prophets and messengers came to a particular city. Some prophets and messengers came to a particular village. Some prophets and messengers were sent to one or two people. The only prophet and messenger that was sent to the entire mankind is our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As Allah Almighty, he says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Indeed, O Muhammad, we sent you a mercy to the entire mankind. All prophets and messengers before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam were sent to a particular nation, to a particular state, to a particular city, to a particular tribe, except Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He was sent to the entire mankind, and it's understandable why, because he is the final and last prophet and messenger that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent. We believe as Muslims that prophets and messengers have a duty, have a mission, have a responsibility, and that is to send the message of Allah that's revealed to them from Allah to the people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends prophets and messengers to communicate to people on the behalf of Allah Almighty. So prophets and messengers only say what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals to them to say. Prophets and messengers will only do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permits them and commands them to do. Prophets and messengers do not commit sins. And this is an important, integral belief in our belief as Muslims, that prophets and messengers are sinless. Sinless means in Arabic, ma'sumin. Ma'sumin, which means they do not commit sins. They do not commit evil actions. Why? Because they are the greatest of examples and role models. Prophets and messengers are the greatest examples and role models for mankind. How could they be? How could they be on the level of being an example and a role model if they are doing wrong actions or doing what they told people not to do or not to do what they told people to do? That's why it's important as a Muslim that I believe all prophets and messengers do not commit sins. No matter how small that sin is, how big the sin is, whether it's a minor sin or a major sin, prophets and messengers do not drink alcohol, as others might say about prophets and messengers. Prophets and messengers do not commit fornication, as others say about their prophets and messengers. Prophets and messengers do not commit evil actions. Prophets and messengers do not even intend evil actions towards anyone or intend evil doings towards anyone. They are the best of people with the best of examples, the best of hearts, the best of actions, the best of examples. So it's not befitting to a prophet and a messenger that Allah chooses to be the best of his creation and then he disobeys Allah and then he neglects the commands of Allah. So we Muslims believe that all prophets and messengers are sinless. They are sinless. Ma'sumin, which means they do not commit sins. Beside prophets and messengers, there is no one sinless. There is no human being beside the prophets and messengers sinless. All prophets and messengers from Adam to Muhammad are sinless. Beside them, all human beings are not sinless. That does not mean that we do not strive to reach the level of perfection. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala embedded in the hearts of the prophets and messengers, in particular of their communication between them and Allah, that gives them the ability not to disobey Allah azza wa jal, not to fall into sins, not to commit sins, because they are the best of examples and they are the best of role models. For that, we Muslims believe in all the prophets and messengers, and we do not distinguish in believing in all of them, even though we believe some are higher in rank and higher to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and closer to Allah than others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it very clear in the Quran al-Kareem that we believe in all prophets and messengers. But is there difference between a level of a prophet and another? Yes. Out of the 114,000 prophets and messengers, there are the top 25 elite prophets and messengers, which are mentioned in the Quran al-Kareem. Out of the 25, there are the top 5 prophets and messengers that Allah describes in the Quran al-Kareem as Ulul Azmi min al-Rusul, those with extreme perseverance and steadfastness, and those 5 prophets and messengers that we call as Ulul Azmi min al-Rusul, the 5 and the most top elite prophets and messengers are Nuh alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, and finally Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then without a doubt, we believe as Muslims that the greatest prophet and the greatest messenger is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam over all prophets and messengers. We believe that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has the highest rank from amongst all the prophets and the messengers because of many, many different things that inshallah I'll be talking about when I talk about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So in Islam, it's so important that we believe in the concept of prophecy. We believe in the concept of messengerhood. And it's important that we follow and obey those prophets and messengers. However, every nation follows the prophet and the messenger that was sent to them. So there is the nation of Nuh, they followed their prophet Nuh. And the nation of Ibrahim, they followed their prophet Ibrahim. And the nation of Musa, and the nation of Dawood, and the nation of Ilyas, and the nation of Isa alayhi salam, they followed their prophet and messenger. And then finally, it was the last and the final prophet and messenger. That was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam. All people during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi salam and after the time of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam must follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It's not accepted in Islam that people follow prophets before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam when they were living after Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And this is common sense, by the way. A common sense that people follow the current ruler and the current king and the current president and the current premier and governor, and they continue moving on. That does not stop them to believe and acknowledge there was a previous king or president or governor. But now this is the current president, this is the current king, this is the current premier, this is the current government. So people follow that. And Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last prophet and messenger. People should be following the last prophet and messenger, and that's Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We believe in the prophet, and we believe in Prophet Isa alayhi salam. We believe in Prophet Musa alayhi salam. We believe in Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. We believe in Prophet Noah. We believe in all the prophets and messengers that in particular Jews and Christians believe in. However, it's not right that we follow them. We follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam because he is the last prophet and messenger. At the same time, we acknowledge them. We believe in them. We respect them. We take them in high regards and we take them as great examples. It is not part of Islam, and it takes you out of Islam if you disbelieve in any of these prophets. If a Muslim says, I do not believe in Prophet Isa, Jesus alayhi salam, then that makes him disbeliever. If a Muslim says, I do not believe in Prophet Musa alayhi salam, then that makes him a disbeliever. If a Muslim says, I don't believe in Prophet Ibrahim, then this makes him a disbeliever. We Muslims believe in all of them as prophets and great prophets and messengers. However, we follow the latest and the last prophet and messenger that was sent to mankind, and that's Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we acknowledge them, we believe in them, we take them in high regards, we take them as great examples. But the legislation that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam came with is the last and the final legislation, and therefore we follow that legislation. Brothers and sisters, the concept of prophecy is so important. You find a lot of anti-religious people want to destroy that concept of believing in the concept of prophecy and messengerhood. Because the moment you abolish the principle of believing in prophets and messengers, then you disconnect yourself from Allah and disconnect yourself from God. Because what we know about Allah came through prophets and messengers. What we know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what Allah azza wa jalla wants from us all came through prophets and messengers. So disbelieving in them, it means disbelieving in Allah. And that's why Allah emphasizes many times in the Holy Quran the importance of believing in prophets and messengers. Denying one prophet and messenger is disbelief. Denying any of the prophets and messengers is disbelief. Allah commands us as Muslims to believe in all prophets and messengers, to believe in all of them. And we believe all prophets and messengers came with one belief. It's not correct that Allah, God, sends different prophets and messengers with different creeds, different beliefs, and different principles. Allah sent all prophets and messengers with one belief, one creed. And that's the monotheism of Islam, to believe in the oneness of God. Allah sent Adam, Allah sent Noah, Allah sent Musa, Allah sent Ibrahim, Allah sent Dawood, Allah sent Sulaiman, Allah sent Isa, and Allah sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam with one message, to believe in Allah, one almighty God. It's not correct, it's not befitting in God, in Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends one prophet, saying to him, you tell your people to believe in my oneness. Then he sends another prophet and he says to him, tell your people to believe in me and my son. And it says another prophet, and he says to him, believe in me and this prophet only. No, Allah sent all prophets and messengers with one message, and that is the monotheism of Islam, believing in the oneness of God. However, some of those prophets and messengers came with different rulings, different legislations. And that's why you find maybe what Musa alayhi salam came with regard to how to pray, how to fast, is different to what Isa alayhi salam came with. What Isa alayhi salam came with is different maybe to what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with regards of praying and worships, with regards of some of the permissible things, some of the forbidden things. However, there were principles, especially on forbidden matters, they all agreed on. No prophet and messenger came and permitted the drinking of alcohol. No prophet and messenger came and permitted the use of usury. No prophet and messenger came and permitted the actions of zina, adultery and fornication. All of them came with the belief of Allah Azza wa Jal and important principles of what's forbidden and what's permitted, but they had some differences when it came to the way of worship, the way of prayers, the way of fasting, and so on. So this is a small nutshell of what Muslims believe in prophets and messengers. They ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us from amongst those who listen and hear, act upon what they listen and hear, and I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us a benefit. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.